bunch of people were asking me in the comments on YouTube what me and Mike think of this oxygen helmet. So I can tell you, me and Mike have each put on at least 13,000 kilometers on this helmet. I've put on probably close to 20,000. And out of all the helmets I've ever owned, this is my favorite. It's super comfortable. It's designed to fit communicators. So your Cardo, your Euclear, your Senna, everything fits perfectly in the helmet. And the helmet itself isn't the most aesthetically pleasing helmet, but if you don't care about aesthetics, I really don't think there is anything better. Me and Mike got wraps on our helmets to make them look a little bit better, but so the helmet is incredible. The best part about it is the heat that comes off the visor is so warm that, like, if it's cold outside, like right now it's negative 25, and this visor at full high on heat is throwing heat onto my face, so it keeps you nice and warm. On top of that, the sun visor sits in a little heated garage, so it's not fogged up there. You bring it down, and if it fogs, you flip it back up into the garage, wait 10 seconds, and then pull it back down, and it's good again. The other thing that I love about these helmets is the light on the back of it. Everyone that I've ridden with, especially at night and during the day, if it's cold and there's a lot of snow dust, it's an awesome feature to have, that bright LED on the back of the helmet, so everyone can see you from behind you, whoever's riding in your group. Especially with the snow dust, it really helps, because it's sometimes hard to see the tail light because it's really low, but your oxygen helmet light is very high up, so people see it, it's super visible. And that's probably like one of my favorite features on the helmet. The long story short is the oxygen helmet is incredible, and I like honestly do think it is the best helmet for most riding. A lot of people like the Mission helmet and the Titan, which are also excellent helmets, but I haven't ridden with them yet, so I don't know. Rich Outdoors has both of them and he loves them, but I've been using the oxygen for a while, and I think it really does. The only time that it's not the best helmet is in the really warm weather. Like if it's above negative 5 degrees Celsius, the helmet is warm. It's a very warm helmet, so it'll get hot pretty quick. But for cold weather riding and for long trips where the weather changes, so like it might be cold one day, might be warm the other day, the oxygen helmet, in my opinion, in me and Mike's opinion, is the best helmet on the market, hands down. Another thing a bunch of people were asking me about the oxygen is, can you ride the helmet without the cord? And in my opinion, no, you can't. I find that on any day, no matter the outdoor temperature, again, I'm a heavy breather, so I guess it might be different for some people, but if that oxygen helmet is not plugged in, my helmet fogs very quickly. And I notice it. Sometimes I forget to plug my connection in on the back of the helmet when I get on the machine. And then within 30 seconds of riding, I pull over and have to put it on because it fogs. So yeah, I don't think that you can really wear the helmet without the cord. I know Gary from Mudbrat says that in some situations he can wear it without the cord, but I haven't been in a situation like that. I feel like every time I've ever ridden with the helmet, if I take the cord off, it fogs. So yeah, I think that's kind of my viewpoint on it.
Another awesome feature of the oxygen helmet is its built-in neck curtain. So I know a lot of guys like to wear a balaclava with their helmet, and I'm the same way. But in the really warm days, you really don't need to. The neck curtain kind of gets tucked into your jacket and it acts like its own balaclava. So overall, me and Mike really love these oxygen helmets. And yeah, they can be a little bit pricey at $750 Canadian plus tax. But at the end of the day, when you're going snowmobiling, which is already an expensive sport, you want to get the helmet that's the most comfortable for you and the most safe and allows you to have the best time when riding. So at the end of the day, you buy the helmet that allows you to do all that and you don't really worry about the money. If you liked that video, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the Sled Addicts YouTube channel, where we release content on everything snowmobiles. Also, hit that bell icon so you can be updated every time we release new videos.